Hello guys, today I'll be doing a CD collection video for multiple bands, those bands being Soundgarden, Nirvana, Stone Temple Pilots, Alice in Chains, Pearl Jam, and more. And basically what I mean by more is these two albums here, and if you haven't heard of these, definitely check them out after this video. Definitely great stuff. But anyways, let's go ahead and move on to the other bands. I'm going to start off with Pearl Jam. So first we have 10, definitely a classic within the grunge genre. Versus, which I think is as good as 10, in my opinion. I really love Versus. You have Vitology, No Code, which has kind of grown on me over time. And finally, Yield, which I think is really good. Now, that's it for Pearl Jam for me. I'm not the biggest fan of 2000s Pearl Jam, except for a few songs like I Am Mine, Come Back, Life Wasted, and a few others. But then you have Lightning Bolt, which I like Sirens and a few other songs, but it's just an album that just doesn't reach me. It just doesn't grab me as much as other albums and all that. But of course, you have the latest album, Gigaton, which I did give a couple listens to, and besides two or three songs, or, well, three or four songs, I just really can't get into the album. Some of the songs do go from one ear and out the other. Not very many, but some of them do, though, for me. But some of the songs I do like are Take the Long Way, Quick Escape, Superblood, Wolf Moon. There might be one or two other ones, but I don't know. I'm just not really feeling that album. And if you like the album, more power to you. It's just not for me, personally. Maybe it's all just a preference thing because music is, again, subjective. But anyways, let's go ahead and move on to Alice in Chains. Facelift, this is probably my favorite from them. Or, well, that album or the next one, Go Back and Forth. Or, not the next one, the one after this one, Sap. Dirt, definitely an excellent album. This album and Facelift do Go Back and Forth for me as my favorite Alice in Chains album. Jar of Flies, which is definitely has some of their best material. Songs like I Stay Away are just excellent, definitely hold up to this day. And then we have their self-titled, which does have a share of underrated stuff like Sludge Factory and Frogs. But next we have Rainier Fog. I loved it when it came out. It definitely has its share of songs I still go back to today. And that's it for Alice in Chains for me. I don't have Black Gives Way to Blue and the Devil Put Dinosaurs here. Thing with those albums, I like two or three songs, and then the rest just doesn't really, again, reach me. But those albums aren't bad. They're just, outside of two or three songs, again, they just don't really grab me that much. And I'm sure some of you guys might understand what I'm getting at there. But anyways, this is what I got for Alice in Chains. Definitely great albums if you haven't heard Alice in Chains. And of course, check them out. And of course, start off with Facelift or Dirt. But anyways, let's go ahead and move on to Stone Temple Pilots. Core. Purple. Tiny Music. Number 4. And Shangri-La-Di-Da. So, I don't have the rest of their albums. I'm not a big fan of their modern stuff. Outside of a few songs, I just can't really get into it. I mean, Jeff Gutt is a good vocalist, but I don't know. His vocals in general just don't make much of an impression on me. They don't really impress me all that much. But again, he is a decent vocalist, though. And there are a share of songs I do like from this modern era, but as when it comes to the albums as a whole, I just can't really get into them, including the self-titled, the last album with Scott Weiland. I couldn't really get into that one, except for maybe one or two songs. But then, of course, you had that EP with Chester Bennington. I mean, I love Chester Bennington. I like Linkin Park, Dead by Sunrise, and Grey Days. But his work on that album, I mean, he sounded great, but the songs just didn't really do much for me in general at the end of the day. But yeah, that's what I got for Stone Temple Pilots. Let's go ahead and move on to Nirvana. Bleach. Nirvana, no, Nevermind, which is definitely a classic, one of the best albums of this genre. But yeah, it's maybe my favorite of the Nirvana albums. And then you have In Utero, which is a very, very, very close second. I mean, those first six songs and the album closer are just excellent. Now you do have songs like songs from 7 to 11, track 7 to track 11. Those songs, I'll be honest, don't have the greatest replay value, but those songs are okay, though. But again, those first six songs and the album closer are just excellent. Just can't touch those. But that's it for Nirvana for me. Let's go ahead and move on to the last band here, Soundgarden. Rest in peace, Chris Cornell. Screaming Life, FOP, which of course combines their two early EPs. Ultramega OK. Louder Than Love. Bad Motor Finger, definitely my favorite Soundgarden album. I love this album. And it does have a share of underrated songs too, like Holy Water, Room 1,000 Years Wide, Somewhere, and a few others. But yeah, I love Bad Motor Finger. And then we have another classic, Super Unknown. And finally, Down on the Upside. Now, as you notice, I don't have their latest album, King Animal. I've given that album a few listens. It's just, besides the song Been Away for Too Long, the rest of the songs just don't really do much for me. Now, throughout the whole album, I think Chris Cornell sounds excellent. His vocals still sound strong on that album, but everything else just doesn't really make much of an impression on me. Now, there is one or two other songs that I do kind of like. I'm just blanking out on the name titles right now. But King Animal, not a bad album. It just doesn't really do much for me. But Chris Cornell, again, does sound great. But anyways, that's my collection for these bands. Let me know your thoughts on my collection. Let me know if you disagree or agree with some of my thoughts here. I'm sure I might face some flack for some of the things I said, and that's okay. I'd still be interested in hearing your guys' thoughts. But anyways, thanks for watching. Please leave a comment and a like. Subscribe. Have a nice day, and take care.